The love that I have for my current president, Barack Hussein Obama, is deep. I feel connected to him in a way that is respectful to Michelle, but also disrespectful at the same time. I long for him in my government, in my life. I feel like I want to sit across from him and drink scotch and tell dirty jokes. I feel that as a human being, God in human form, I should say, he has blessed us with his political prowess, his kindness, and he's inspiring all of us to be better people. And I will never not tweet him very late at night, "You up?" Because he is. We know he is. I don't think he sleeps. When you're that perfect, you don't need sleep. When you have a woman of color in that position who is smart, funny, warm, thoughtful, deeply compassionate, it is inspiring to be around and to be alive during, like, what a time to be alive, to have that as an example. She's not just talking about stuff, she's about stuff. This new phase of her life, this sort of post-White House exploration of who she is and what she's offering, I feel like the shackles are off almost, that like now that she's out of the White House, she can fully blossom and be in our lives in new, interesting ways. I tweet every day since the election, almost every day since the election, that Trump is trash. It's blowing off steam at the very fundamental level, but it's a reminder every day that this is not normal. And I think it's important for us to know that this current administration is not indicative of who we are as a people and is not representative of me. So something so silly as a tweet, "You are trash," every day, it's an exercise for me mentally to check in with myself, to remind myself that it's not normal and we have to fight for change. One of my favorite definitions of comedy, it's the truth quickly. I think that it's an art form and a community that has always drawn from people who are from the most disenfranchised groups, to be able to be a part of that community and to use it as a tool to get through this current administration. In our darkest times, we want to have a way to grieve communally. And a lot of time it's through the catharsis of laughter, where you're able to enjoy the hope in a moment, which is, it's hard now, but we're able to laugh because we know that it's temporary. I could be eating a beignet right now, but I sat down to see Michelle, so is she really not